Hi everyone. I miss all of you. I hope you and your families are staying safe and healthy. And I imagine that this has been quite an adjustment for you. I know this has been an adjustment for me in my house. But you may be wondering why it's been so long since you've seen me. You've seen your other teachers. They've been posting a lot of things, but you haven't seen too much of me. Well, think about the last time you saw me at school. I had a big old belly. I don't have that belly anymore because on March 21st, I had my son, Ryan Eric Peterson. He was born March 21st at 1:11 a.m. He was 7 pounds and 12 ounces. I'm happy to say that he's doing really well. He's a healthy boy. He cries a lot. He basically is eating, sleeping, and pooping, as most babies do. But he's a lot of fun. We're getting to know him. And babies are a lot of work, as your moms and dads can relate. So last week, I was really, really busy getting to know my boy and figuring out how to have a baby. And so now this week, I'm trying to catch up to what all of your other teachers have been doing with Google Classroom and Google Chat and all those different things. So your classroom teachers were nice enough to let me post this video onto their Google Classrooms. I'm working on getting my Google Classroom ready. And so I'll have that information for you soon. And I hope that by next week, my videos will be on my Google Classroom. Sorry if my eyes are kind of everywhere. It's hard for me to to look right into the camera. I'm looking at myself. I'm looking at my notes. So I'll have that information for you soon. So let's get started with some music. I want to teach you a little bit about a song that you should all be familiar with. That's my dog, if you hear moaning. So in this lesson, I'm hoping to get you up on your feet and moving around. And since this lesson is pre-recorded, I'm hoping that you guys are actually going to get up and move around. So let's listen to the song first. I'm pulling it up on my phone. And let's see if we can figure out how the song wants us to move. Okay, so we're going to listen to that much of the song again, and this time I want you to do as I do. This is what we call a tapping page. So this is basically just a musical roadmap as to how the song goes, and it divides it into sections. So now we're gonna just add movements to the song. So I'm gonna play that much again. And this time I want you to do as I do. Remember, I'm trusting you because this is a live video. Thank you. There's a little more. So, now I'm wondering if this song sounds familiar to you guys. Think about the tune. Think about what that sounds like to you. I'm going to give you a minute or a few seconds. I hope that most of you thought of Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star. And the movements that we did were all about that, right? I did this for the stars, and we made this diamond shape for like a diamond in the sky, right? Now, try to think of another song where you sing the same tune, but you sing different words. So you're still singing, but you're not singing Twinkle Twinkle Little Star, you're singing different words. Can you think of another song with the same tune? How about the ABC song, right? And how about Ba Ba Black Sheep, right? Ba ba black sheep, have you any wool? Yes sir, three bags full. Maybe that's a song that you know. All right. So the same tune can have different lyrics or words. So that's something important that you need to know. Now, what you may not know about that song is where it originally came from. It originally came from this little guy. So this man, well, he grew up to be a man eventually. In this picture, he's a child. But his name is Wolfgang Amadeus Mozart. Maybe your moms and dads, when you were babies, played baby Mozart for you. They say that when babies hear Mozart, it makes them smarter. So I am making my baby listen to a lot of Mozart because I want my baby to be smart. So I'm going to now continue the song, and we're going to play a little bit more of it because, believe it or not, there's more to the song. Let's see what this music is now telling us, telling our bodies to do. Whoa. So that sounded similar but different, right? And the fancy schmancy name for that is a theme and variations. So for my second graders especially, I want you to think about what a variation is. What is a variation? Think about the word variety, right? If we have a variety of fruits and vegetables, what does that mean? Well, it means that you have different fruits and vegetables. You have apples, bananas, oranges, grapes, asparagus, carrots, Brussels sprouts, all of your favorite vegetables, right? So a variety means you have something different. A variation means that there's a change. So you have the theme, right? We all know Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star, that theme. And then they change it up. They make it fancy. They do all kinds of things to it to make it a little bit different. But you can still kind of hear the tune, right? You can still sort of sing Twinkle Twinkle Little Star, even through all that fancy schmancy stuff, right? So that is what a theme and variations is. So now that we've heard this variation, let's see what that part of the song, what it makes your body do. Now think about our roadmap, right? We had the star section and we had the diamond section. See if you can do one thing for the star section and something different for the diamond section. And then do what you did again for the star section. If you want to take a minute to practice that, to maybe think of a movement for the stars and then think of a movement for the diamonds, feel free to pause this video, make a plan, and then hit the play button again, and then try it. See if it works. So I'm going to just keep this video going, and you're going to hear another variation. So listen to it for a second, and then think about what you want to do. So believe it or not, there are many, many more variations to the song. If you want to hear them, here is the name of the song as it was originally. It's a little bit upside down. I wish I could write it the other way for you so that it would be flipped over. But if you want to pause it and try to read it backwards, you can type this in to YouTube. And you'll find it. It's actually 13 minutes and 40 seconds long, which is a long time. But if you want to hear all the variations, some of them are pretty cool. So I highly recommend that for you. So let's sum up everything that we learned today. We learned that, let me show you that picture again because I love this picture. Mozart is the guy that Twinkle Twinkle Little Star originally came from. We learned that you can have different lyrics to the same tune. And we also learned that a theme and variations, wow, that might be the fanciest thing you've ever learned this year, is when you have a tune and you make it different and you make it fancy. So I hope that this lesson was enjoyable for all of you. Thank you for paying attention. Keep up the good work that you're doing in this new uncharted territory of online learning. I never thought I'd see the day where kindergartners and pre-Kers even had to learn online, but you guys are doing that and you're doing a really great job. So keep up the good work. Hopefully I will see you soon when this whole thing is over. Love you guys and enjoy the rest of your day.